Hello, dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today waking up from a long, dark nap. And we're going to pick up right where we left off. We've got some sleep, got some shut-eye. Now it's time to feed so that we don't starve to death. Now, happily, you'll see after a few-hour nap under the covers, our cold has gone all the way down to zero. Fatigue is now ready to go so we can run even further. Hunger and thirst is getting on up there, though, so let's go ahead and feed our little guy. He needs a little candy bar. Give him a Snickers. He's getting a little bit grumpy. Chow down on that for a few extra calories. Still extremely hungry, as you can tell. These guys can eat a lot, you know? They eat a lot. Let's go with one of our MREs, because this has like almost 2,000 calories in it. Let's pick the one that's in the worst condition, though, and eat that before it rots. So now we've upped our calorie count a significant portion. Let's check on our hunger. It is now good to go. I wonder if we could have done without eating that just yet. Probably so. But oh well. We're still very thirsty, however. So we've got some water from some of our little canteens, and we're going to be able to drink those. And I think now we should be good to go. He is very famished. You know, the cold can do that to you sometimes. So you'll notice that much quicker loading screen. That's very, very much an improvement. And we want to go... Is that immediately a wolf? Am I going to subject myself to a wolf attack just for science? Okay. Is that what you want? Is that what you, the viewer at home, wants to see? You want to see me sneak up on a wolf? I wish I could attack it. I've got a tool, but unfortunately I cannot equip said tool. Let's see. Nope. We can only use it to salvage meat. All right. The wolf has smelled our scent. He's now on the prowl. For science, I will show you what a wolf attack looks like. It's kind of terrifying, though, because he's like a shark. He knows where I am. He's going to bust out running at me here in just a second. Can we outrun the wolf? That is what I'm curious of. Well, he's definitely hot on the trail. We're just going to let him do his thing. Please don't hurt me too bad, Mr. Wolf. There he goes, taking off at a run. All right, we have the left mouse button. Just click and tab, and then we can finally kill him. There we go. We have to left mouse that meter all the way full, and then right click to attack the wolf. We're down to 36% condition. I nearly died to show you what that wolf attack looks like. We have an infection risk and blood loss. Let's quickly sort over to our first aid and start taking care of ourselves. Antiseptic to clean the wound, probably. All right, let's use that first. Applying the antiseptic now so the infection risk should be diminished, and then we are going to probably bandage that up. So the blood loss, if any, should stop, and the infection risk should go away, hopefully. I think we only really need antibiotics to stop an infection if it has already happened. Now, the risk you run after getting attacked, of course, is once you've used that antiseptic, there's no more. That's all you get. Where did this energy bar come from? I guess I missed that. So yeah, we're not going to be able to treat any wounds in the future. We're just going to be able to bandage them up and take some antibiotics as a last-ditch effort. But maybe you're out of food. Maybe you're going really hungry and you need this wolf carcass in order to survive. You have to harvest the meat or else you're going to die. So that is a very real possibility. You could try to fight the wolf. Of course, if you can find a firearm or a gun, that's a much safer way to do it. Let's go ahead and use our hunting knife here to harvest some of the meat. It's going to take... 16 minutes, it says, to harvest some of that. With the hunting knife, it's going to be so much faster, so much better. And now we've got 2 kilograms of wolf meat. But it degrades the hunting knife each time it does it. Now, you'll look at the difference between these. Not using the hunting knife, it's going to take almost twice as long. Actually, like 4 times as long. So, hunting knife is really, really good when doing this. We can also get the hide from it. Not sure what this is going to be good for. Perhaps, like, crafting clothes of some kind? I'm willing to spend 20 minutes just to find out. And then finally, we can gut it. I'm not sure why we're gutting it, but we are making the most of this wolf carcass, and now it's pretty much been completely consumed. Since you really get so cold so quickly in this frigid wasteland, let's take a look at some of the other menu options while we are recovering our cold. It's probably going to be worthwhile to take another nap. Pretty much anytime you get cold, take a nap. It's the best thing to do. And I think you do get a bedroll so that you can sleep anywhere you want, even if the bed is not available. So you can just place that down at any time and take a little nap. It's pretty nice like that. So let's pick this back up, put it in our inventory. Just wanted to show you some of the options you have here. We can start a fire, forage for wood, what are we repairing? Oh, Italics has figured it out. So if there's something really valuable, like for example this can opener, we can use some scrap metal to attempt to repair one of our tools. That's interesting. We have a chance of success, which I do not like that at all. 60% sounds so poor. But I guess the more you repair, the higher your repair skill goes. In addition, you can harvest something to try to maybe get some more scraps of things to repair with. Resting on the beds for about an hour will take you down from around here to around here. So 2 hours is going to clear your cold and fatigue pretty much anytime you want. And then you can just head back outside and go die outside. Doesn't that sound exciting? All right. It get a little dark. The weather is changing. You'll see it's not quite so windy now, but perhaps it won't be as frigid either. Let's see what the actual temperature is. Minus 10. Okay, well, I stand corrected. If we continue to head down this way, I'm curious what we'll find. I'd love to find a rifle because hunting some deer sounds pretty cool. We've got some wolf meat in our inventory still. Not sure what the guts are going to be good for. Looks like guts are used for crafting and repair. Not sure how you use guts for repair, but you get the idea. Each of the items that you're going to be harvesting off these animals are useful somehow. That's the point. So you have some options there with how you're going to use your new prey. Hello, Mr. Buck. Will you come be my friend? I don't even want to kill you because I physically can't kill you unless I hit you with a lantern. So if you'd like to just walk along with me, we can protect each other. You can be used as my wolf bait. I'll let you run out ahead of me, attract any wolves that might be nearby, and then they'll chase you instead of chasing me. And of course, as you're exploring within the sandbox, it's just fun coming across random things here and there, like this backpack, which I had no idea this was here, but why not grab a sewing kit out of it to repair some clothing? So if anything starts breaking, we're going to be able to put it back together a little bit. Looks like we may be coming up on some other camp. Logs everywhere, which leads me to talk about the graphics. I don't think you need me to tell you this game is pretty beautiful. It looks really nice. The skyboxes, the colors, all of it just melds together so well. Of course, the changing weather, that's very obvious if you shouldn't be in it. For example, we're not terribly cold right now. It's cold, but it's just a light snow. When you see that wind kick up, you know things are about to get bad. So I love the visual representation with the weather and how you can just innately know when you're in a dangerous and precarious situation. So we got a sign here with an arrow pointing up. This looks to be like some kind of tower ahead. I guess we'll explore it. It's 4:17 p.m. It's going to be getting dark pretty soon. And you definitely want to have a shelter for night. Now the question of course becomes, Italics, is this game worth $20? That is a difficult question to answer for any game in early access, because you just simply don't know what's coming on the horizon. I like the general gameplay mechanics, I love the scavenging as I've said before, the general world is a pleasure to explore. It does seem like it could get a little bit old if you play the same map over and over, remember where all the locations are, and then it just becomes a matter of RNG, being able to get just the right loot, just the right gear from the places that you are knocking out one after the other. So, that being said, it's going to be nice to have a kind of a campaign story mode and another sandbox map. So the more sandbox maps they add, the more longevity I'm going to see within this game. And of course, just the more basic mechanics that they add as well, some visual representation would go a long way. Like just clicking eat and seeing a bar is not nearly as satisfying as witnessing the action. Similarly, taking a drink, similarly equipping clothes. So a little bit of extra detail there, I think, would make this a much more fulfilling experience. It's a lot of fun right now. It's a difficult game to survive in. So if you want a challenge, this is pretty challenging, I gotta say. Hiking up this mountain, fatigue and cold is rising rapidly. I'm glad that the weather condition has been on my side. And for some reason, I also feel really short. I just feel like a toddler looking out over this little rail. I don't know why I am so short. And I don't recommend jumping off any cliffs here. But we found a lookout tower. Now, isn't this interesting? For me personally, I'm enjoying what I'm playing here. I enjoy especially the aesthetics of the game. But the question is, how long can you play it without getting bored of the mechanics? Because the mechanics as they stand right now are really just eat and drink and run to the next place. So I can't wait to see what else is added to this game in the future, because it's just so much fun seeing all the different items that you can find, from dog food to flares. and I hear a bunch of birds. Hopefully that doesn't mean anything is bad coming my way. This is a bit of an ominous place, isn't it? I don't think I've actually seen any birds. Maybe they don't exist just yet. It would be really cool to see some kind of buzzards flying around over some kills. That would be pretty scary. Let's head up here and see if there's anything noteworthy within this lookout tower. This is definitely where we are going to be calling home for the night. There are some birds. Hooray, birds. They're flying over the dead corpse. Okay, so maybe that's already in the game, and I just said that completely for no reason whatsoever. Let's look in through the windows here. I see a hatchet. Can we use that as a weapon? Oh no, this is not even a separate interior. That's cool. If every single building in the game was like this, with windows you could actually see out, and just the ability to come in here, scavenge for all these different things. Look at this. A one-handed hatchet, good for splitting wood, or to hack meat in a pinch. Why can't I use them as weapons? You should be able to melee in this game. That's another thing I would like to see added. You can never really truly go wrong with a second can opener. Plenty of food, plenty of peaches, first aid. This looks like a great place. Rifle ammunition. Is there a rifle in this room? Could there be? We'll have to look. Could it be in this metal container, even though that would make no sense whatsoever? Shoes. You know, shoes. Who doesn't need shoes in the freezing cold? This place is a gold mine. There are so many things here. Once you exhaust these resources, I pity you, because you're not going to find anything better than this, I don't think. Maybe you will. I don't know. I haven't really explored all that much. This is going to be a great place to call home for now. I wonder if the radio works. Let's finish picking up these. Try turning it on. Anybody? Nope. Okay, I guess that electromagnetic storm must have disabled everything up here. No rifles, guys. Sorry, no guns yet, unless it's underneath the bed. Quick. Okay, you can use a pry bar for locked containers. That's pretty cool. Did not know that at all. Let's go ahead and get a fire started as we close this video out. Let's use some of our nice cedar firewood with some accelerant. Actually, we don't even need accelerant. We got a 75% chance. That seems pretty solid.
Can't feel my feet.
All right, you can't feel his feet. We gotta get this guy some fire so that he warms up a little bit, gets a little toastier. Anyways, guys, if you enjoyed this video and you want to see some more survival, maybe I can pick up right where I left off here in this little base that we've got going for ourselves up at the top of the mountain. I really want to find a rifle. Anyway, let me know what you think by, of course, leaving a like on the videos that you enjoy, leaving your thoughts below. Again, if you like the game, check out the link below. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Italics, and if you'll excuse me, I'm going to take a little nap.